Imagine if video editing was as simple as editing an image. Please welcome Ruixin Wang with Project Frame Forward. Welcome.
Hello.
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 Hi, Jessica.
Hi.
Thank you, Paul, for the introduction. Welcome. Are you guys ready for some videos?
Woo!
So video editing has evolved a lot, but it's still very difficult to do compared to image editing. Think of when was the last time you actually edited a personal video compared to a personal image when you uploaded it to Instagram. So Project Frame Forward is a way that leverages the power of Gen AI and lets you edit the first frame of the video when you want to edit the video. Let me show you how easy this can be. So I have this video here, and I want to remove the middle person, OK? So the first thing I'll do is I'll extract the first frame. So this is the first frame of the video. Now I simply go into Photoshop, and you all saw the amazing trace erase. Why don't we just do that? So I can select this person in Photoshop, and I can just use the trace erase button, OK? And this is going to remove the person, OK?
Yeah.
Hold on. This is what you've seen. All right, so now we have this edit. I can come back, and I can load my edit. OK, so this is just a single image. Then I start propagating. So our model takes two things, the input video and then the edited first frame. And it's going to analyze the entire video and decides what to do with the rest of the video. And just like that.
Wow. That girl's going to be mad as hell she got cut from that. Are you gonna,
what happened to her?
If she got cut from that and one of those two girls put that on Instagram.
Oh, man.
So we removed the girl from the first frame.
Yeah, and then I bet.
Now AI helps us remove her from the entire video. So this is great. Not for her.
No, that girl was drama.
I
that
hope
girl
she's
was
okay.
drama that weekend.
So our tool actually does not use any masking or tracking. And to show you this, let me do this example.
Cool.
So here, we're going to remove the car and the smoke, OK? So just like before, let me extract the first frame. And so I have my first frame here. Instead of just going back and forth to Photoshop, I'm just going to select this car here and then remove. All this is just image, OK? This is calling the Photoshop backend API to remove the car and the smoke, OK? So this is still using trace erase. So now you see the car and the smoke is removed, and then we can start propagating. So this example is obviously very difficult because the car and the cameras are both moving very fast, and you see the smoke is actually occupying a large portion of the frame, and it's actually transparent. So we try all the video trackers right now. None of this will work, okay, including the one in After Effects right now. And we asked a professional video editor to do this example, and it took them 4 hours just to draw the mask around the smoke because the tracker failed. And let's see how our model does. With one single click of the button, the car and the smoke is now removed.
That's the hardest example I could think of right
That's,
there.
Yeah,
right?
It's all drifting around, yeah. That driver's like, I did all that work.
Yes. Let's hope the driver is okay. But if you look at the if you look at the background, you'll see all the camera motions, the color, the mountain, the sky, the racetrack. There is actually a crack on the racetrack. It's perfectly reconstructed in the edited video.
Wow.
Now, cool. I'm done with removing things, okay? This is a cat video that I really love.
Aww.
Let's not remove it, okay? I love this shot, but I feel like it's missing a little bit of something. So let's try to add a little bit of flair. So I extracted the first frame, just like before. And this time, I'm going to draw a mask. OK, just something like this. And then here, I can type in things. And this time, I'm going to use a different image tool. I'm going to use GenFill, or Generative Fill, in Photoshop to add a puddle to the scene. OK, so now we have our puddle.
Wow.
All right, so we have our puddle. Hold on, this is just an image. And you can notice that there is actually reflections of the cat on the puddle. So let's try our model on this one. So this is more difficult because now our model needs to actually understand physics, like how puddle works, how reflections work.
Wait for it.
No way!
Aww.
And you see?
It's amazing.
Kitty.
With a click of the button, I can now animate the cat with the puddle on the ground perfectly,
wow.
And the reflections moves along with the cat, just
wow.
like in the real world. Let me move on to the last example. So this is I want to show you how this tool can be useful in real world scenario. And real world is very messy. Just look at this wedding video
yeah,
from.
Yeah, this is tough. This one's tough to look at.
Yeah.
From.
This is gonna.
Exactly.
This technique's a little much.
Yes, yes. So, all right, so case in point, you can see there are a lot of issues in this video, right?
Yes.
There are people in the background, the sky is overexposed, and you can see the air is hazy. And so not a single edit, like inserting an object or removing an object, will fix this video. So let's try our project frame forward on this one. So first thing, just like before, we extract the first frame.
Where are you going to start with this one, boss?
Yeah.
And we'll do this in Photoshop. And because we can spend all our efforts on the image part, not the video, you don't have to go back and forth in masking and tracking, we can spend all the time we want on this one. And clearly, it's an important one, right? So we asked a professional image editor to do this one. And this is the before and after that he created.
Wow.
And
very nice.
The thing I want to illustrate, though, is you look at how many different edits he's applying to this image to make it look great. You know, the sunset transformation
uh-huh.
comes from a lot of different complex edits added on this single photo. Now, once I have this, I can simply load it up. Let me just clear this. And I have this edited first frame. I can start propagating. The best thing here is that our model actually does not take any longer. It analyzes all the edits that you added to the first frame and then decides what to propagate and what does not.
Wow.
That's
wow.
Amazing.
That helped. That helped.
And I'm going to bring up this panel so you can see how perfectly
yeah.
the original structure
wow.
is preserved. You know, the couples, the flowers, the mountains,
wow.
everything
wow.
is perfectly preserved, just
even
like the
her
original.
Even the veil looks amazing.
Even the veil. That is
so
Project Frame Forward.
Wow.
So impressive. Thank you so much. That was
wow.
amazing.
Interactive, surgically precise video editing through Photoshop. Thank you.
Yeah,
wow, that's
wow.
amazing.
That was amazing. That was amazing.
All right.